That's going in the video. What is going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. I know a lot of you guys have been requesting, a lot of comments have been saying that you guys wanted the tips, tricks kind of video. We're gonna show you guys what we've been using. Rods, reels, line, lures, net,
everything.
The whole ball of wax. Yeah. Everything we got in the bag, you guys are gonna know exactly what we've been using in the past videos catching these fish. And it has been a grind this year, to say the least.
It is still early, guys, and we are gonna show you all the techniques, tricks, and tips on how we catch our king salmon. All right, let's get to the lures that we use.
There they are. All right, guys, so we're gonna start off with the lures that we, I would say, use most often, catch the most fish on early season.
Yeah, so our go-to lures, I would say, early season is gonna be a half-ounce Castmaster right here. Some good colors in this are silver and chartreuse, chartreuse and white, and gold. That's our primary colors. Castmasters are a great option for early season king salmon fishing because they have a quick whip up and then a real slow flutter down. And what happens is those salmon grab that Castmaster on the flutter down. So those are great early season baits.
All right, guys, another good bait early season is this. It's actually a Cabela's brand jigging spoon. If you guys want to pick these up, just literally go to Cabela's. But definitely replace the hooks because these hooks suck. I'll play a clip, but if you don't replace the hooks, this is exactly what's gonna happen.
Ho ho ho! No!
Yeah, your hooks are gonna bend out, and it's gonna be ass, and you're not gonna catch any fish. You guys definitely want to replace the hooks if you guys are getting these jigging spoons, but they work early season, especially when you want to cast from shore, and you really want to get that bait out there. If you're using a bait cast or a spinning setup, whatever, you really want to whip that bait out there. These 2 ounce jigs, definitely where it's at early season.
All right, so the next bait I would say that a lot of people tend to throw are the KO wobblers. If you guys haven't tossed a KO wobbler before,
what in the hell are you doing?
What the hell are you doing? Exactly. These things are really versatile. I would say pretty much every fish would hit this bait. It's like the perfect size. These spoons are really good. They have a little tail on the back, so that tail actually makes noise when it goes through the water, and it gives a little bit of vibration as well. Make sure that you're letting it sink at least to a 10 count and letting it sink all the way to the bottom, because the majority of the salmon that you're catching early season are gonna be in that bottom 8 feet of the water column. Now, a good option during the day is gonna be your silver and green, or your silver and blue. And then during the night, we have really good luck with the green and glow, or any of the glow KO wobblers. Again, these are great baits, especially early season.
We're gonna go kind of in order of the season, how the season goes. So I'm gonna go to more of a versatile bait for a little bit more when they're in the harbor. Fish are a little more aggressive just because if you're plopping them in front of the face, the males, they don't like that. So they'll eat you. So a blade bait, these blade baits right here work very well. When you're fishing these blade baits, along with another bait that I'm gonna get to here in a second, as long as you're casting it out, letting it fall, probably count to about 30. You wanna get that bait all the way on the bottom, and you just wanna give her some pops, almost like you're walleye fishing. And if you get in front of a fish's face, they're gonna take you for a ride. Another option later in the season, guys, is gonna be these Eurotackle Z-Vibers. These things are badass. They're super loud, they rattle a lot. And the thing with late season fish is they're not really looking to chase bait and necessarily eat, but the way these fish react to these baits, they're obnoxious, they're loud, they piss them off, and that's exactly what gets them to strike. They're not in there to eat, like I said. Once they kind of get in there, they're in there to spawn and die. Eric Hottie, the man himself, developed some great baits to use out in the Great Lakes for some kings, some rainbow trout. If you guys want to pick them up, I'll leave the description down below. Literally all of these baits, all of our rods, which will be talked about next, but literally everything that you see in this video, I will attempt to leave a link down below. And if you guys can't find it, just leave a comment and I'll type in, you know, a response. That's about it for the baits. So we're gonna get into the rods next. Next up, these are our bait casting rods. These are the rods we use early season to whip those baits out there as far as possible. And as you guys know, for those of you guys that kingfish, the king fishing can be really tough. The farther out you are and the deeper you're fishing from shore, that is, the more likely you are to catch one. These are our custom Della Bay rods. We customize these ourselves strictly for this type of fishing. So if you guys want to grab one, I'll leave the link down below. These are 8 foot heavy bait casting rods, moderate to fast action. It's super perfect for casting those big lures out because you still got about, I'd say about 18 inches of good flex in the tip, and it's got a really strong backbone. So you're really ripping those hooks into the fish's mouth.
Yeah guys, these are great rods. We got these paired up with Corrado DC's excellent reels. We can cast them out with these things. And then our line choice. I know a lot of you guys have been asking, what kind of line are you guys using? We are using braid. We are using braid connected to a fluorocarbon leader. Specifically, a fluorocarbon leader that's anywhere from 7 to 12 feet long. So I know a lot of you guys have also been asking, what pound fluorocarbon and what pound braid are you guys using on your setup? So on our setups, we're using anywhere from 10 to 20 pound fluorocarbon, depending on what you're fishing around. If you're fishing around more of a rocky area, I would go with a heavier fluorocarbon line, probably a 15 to 20 pound. And then if you're fishing more of a jig bite in the middle of the harbor where you're not gonna get caught on rocks, go with more of a 10, 12 to 14 pound fluorocarbon. That's gonna do the trick. And then with braid, braid is strong. You don't need heavy braid to do the trick. Your 10 to 15 pound braid is gonna do the trick when you're salmon fishing.
Yeah guys, these rods were also developed to have a little bit of skein flex in them too. For those of you guys that don't know skein fishing, it's with a bobber. And I actually have mine rigged up right now for skein. But like I said, they were developed strictly for casting out those big lures, but that flex and the mid flex of the rod is perfect for whaling those hook sets into those bobber drops and really sinking those hooks in. So it's kind of a little bit of a, you get a little bit of both.
Yeah, come November, these rods are gonna be put to good use jigging lake trout. So guys, if you guys like jigging,
oh yeah,
if you guys like jigging deep water fish in 40, 50, sometimes 100 feet of water, these rods are the way to go. They have the backbone to really jig those heavy jigs and fight those fish out of deep water. So
now comes my favorite part, our brand new skein rods.
Yes.
All right guys, I'm excited. We just got these rods in literally like, I think 2 days ago, and shout out to Della Bay for hooking it up. These are 11'3" medium rods, moderate action, and these are gonna rip some lips this year. These things were strictly developed for skein fishing. That super long rod is gonna give a good bend and really allow those head shakes to be absorbed when we're ripping some lips.
These rods are absolutely gorgeous. They come in two pieces, so they collapse down in your car for a packable rod for sure. So these rods are absolutely beautiful, and they're custom made in Elk River, Minnesota, guys.
Yeah, I'm honestly impressed with how light they can make these rods. I got other Della Bay rods too, and they hold up just fine. And they're all extremely light. They're super nice, especially when you're holding it. Who wants to be holding a 10 pound rod? you know, you're getting fatigued, and you're not enjoying yourself. But this way, you're out there. You're not getting fatigued. You're catching fish. And the head shakes are going to be absorbed perfectly with these rods. I was texting Sam, and I actually had him send me a few clips of him actually creating these rods. So I will show you guys kind of, or he will show you a little bit of what goes on down in the rod shop in Elk River, Minnesota.
Yeah guys, can't stress the importance of a good skein rod, and these rods are sure to be absolutely great this season. The importance of a long rod when skein fishing is the difference between a 10 fish day and a 2 fish day. And when I mean 10 fish day to a 2 fish day, we've had those days. These rods are definitely gonna do the trick, absorb those big, long head shakes, and really gonna put a stick to them when we're setting the hook bobber fishing skein this year.
Yep, and like Aiden said, the reason you guys want a long rod, I know you guys are probably like, why the hell you want an 11 foot rod? But the reason is, just like he said, those head shakes, they have to be absorbed. And when you're fishing right below you, there's a lot of stress that happens on the line when you're setting that hook vertically, especially because it's a snap. The bobber's already dropped, and it's a quick snap. It's not a lay into the fish. So it's a lot of stress, and you're using light line. On these rods, we're using 15 pound braid to about a 12 to 14 pound fluorocarbon leader.
Sometimes 10 when it comes early season and the water is very clear.
Yeah, and the reason I was texting Sam and I was like, it's gotta do this, it's gotta be that, is because if you have a stiff rod when you're skein fishing, for one, you're gonna set the hook and you're gonna break off. Or two, you're gonna set the hook, you're not gonna break off, and you're gonna snap your rod in half. These fish are strong, they're heavy, and if you guys don't have the proper equipment, your fish are gonna not be landed. And like Aiden said, it's the difference between a 10 fish, 12 fish, 15 fish day, or a 1, 2, or 0 fish day. I mean, it can be that drastic. We've had those problems not landing fish, and we have those problems no more with these rods. So It's gonna be an awesome year, but now we're gonna get over to our casting rods. We now got our casting rods, our beautiful Della Bay casting rods. These are both 7'4" medium fast action rods, and they get the job done. As you can see, I still got my cast master on here from literally this morning. These rods do the job. It's got that perfect amount of flex to really whip the cast out there and get that bait out there, but it's just got enough backbone to lay the hook into that fish.
It's also got a really sensitive tip, so when you get that quick snap up on your jigging, you can really feel that bait just trickle down on the fall.
We also got these rods paired up with a PC Fun Carbon X 3000 size. These things are badass, and for the price, guys, you literally can't beat it. They're less than $100 right now on the website, and you guys can even get more dollars off if you use the code down below. But this reel has been my favorite reel. I've used many reels for King Salmon. It's super light, so you're not feeling that fatigue. And that's another thing about these rods, guys. Feather light. They're super duper light. And I actually got, this is unreleased, but I actually have this handle here. I kind of forget what they call it, but it's like a little bit lighter than cork. I mean, it is extremely light. You can cast all day. You're not feeling fatigued. You got 15 pound braid on here, and I use a 12 pound fluorocarbon leader, also about 7 feet long, depending on the water clarity. Buddy wants to talk about it in the head.
Alrighty, guys, I just wanted to throw in a quick little thing about nets. Not a lot of people think nets are important, but a net is really highly important when you're kingfishing. This is the clam.
How else are you gonna land a fish?
Well, the kind of net anyway. A lot of people use crap nets and they rip them. Alright guys, so this is the clam catch and release net. These nets just came out, I think, a couple years ago. They're great nets. They're super strong, super sturdy, and these things extend out probably about 9-10 feet out, and that's what you need. It's also got a giant basket on it, so those kings can fit in there and you're not gonna lose fish. Another thing I wanted to bring up is the Della Bay Sun Hoodies. These things are absolutely phenomenal. I love it, I love it, I love it. That is what I can say. These things are, they're light, they're breathable, they're SPF 50, so the sun's not gonna get to your skin. They have a built-in mask that goes over your face, a built-in hood. We use these all the time, guys. This is to keep that sun or that wind or the bugs out of your face. Can't get much better than these, guys. Go to the Della Bay website, go pick one out. They are something that would be a great gift for someone, either for the holidays, the birthday, or just a quick buy before the salmon season really gets into full swing.
Yeah, they're pretty inexpensive. A lot of companies tend to rip you off for sun hoodies, and a lot of them don't even come with a mask. And like Aiden said, for the sun, the wind, and the bugs. The bugs are the worst. If you guys fish on Lake Michigan, you guys know that the bugs suck. There's flies, there's gnats, there's mosquitoes, biting flies. There's literally every freaking flying object in the air that you can possibly imagine trying to bite you. So these things are fantastic. You're like literally 100% covered. They're super light. We're kind of in the making of possibly coming out with some merch, and I'm wearing the prototype merch right now. It's a Wisconsin Anglers merch. Yeah, so this merch is, I don't know, is it good or is it bad? Leave a comment down below. Let me know what you guys think of the merch design, of the merch products, and this is also that SPF crap. It's like one of those performance shirts. You guys, yeah, the dry wick, like performance type athletic shirts, if you will. But yeah, that's kind of what we wear. This is literally, we either wear this or we wear that every day. But yeah, guys, that is gonna do it for today's video. Kind of random, kind of all over the place, but now you guys kind of know, literally, this is the stuff we're using to catch these fish every single day that we're fishing. And now you guys know exactly what we're using. If you guys wanna get literally anything that we talked about, the baits, the rods, the reels, the line, all that kind of jazz, I'll leave it down below for you guys. And some of them, you'll be able to get some very good discounts. So even if you guys are kind of on the fence or you just wanna check it out, definitely go down below, check out some websites, and do some fishing shopping, because the kings are just starting to come in. It's very early. Like I said, we fished all week and it has been a tough week to say the least. And the fish are slowly coming in.
The height of the season is only a few weeks away. So guys, whether it be Christmas, early king season, whatever, pick you guys stuff up some of this gear. It's gonna help you, I promise, catch a lot of these kings that are sometimes very elusive to target.
You're damn right. With that all being said, guys, I hope you guys did enjoy it. If you guys haven't seen the King videos, and for some reason, if you guys are new here, I'm Tony.
I'm Aiden.
That's Aiden. We do a lot of King salmon fishing, obviously, because we made a whole video about it. Like I said, if you guys are new here and you like these kinds of videos and you like to see some big fish get caught, hit that subscribe button down below. Leave a like on this video, letting us know that you guys liked this kind of concept of us letting you know what we kind of use on a daily basis. And we can do some more of these for different species of fish. I know the brown trout through the ice. Walleye. That's another big thing.
Big walleye guy.
Yeah. Buddy's a big walleye guy.
Walleye.
So if you guys want to see this kind of stuff, definitely show your support down below by hitting that like button. It'll kind of just let us know that this is what you guys want to see. But if you guys haven't checked out the King videos so far this year, I don't know what you're doing, but apparently you've been watching some pretty bad YouTube. So go check the recent videos down below. I'll leave those at the top of the description as well. But I hope you guys did enjoy. Make sure you guys go leave a like on this video. Hit that subscribe button down below. Leave a comment. Any sort of comment will do. If you guys want to let us know about the merch, drop a comment. Drop a comment about some other questions you guys might have or some other video ideas you guys want to see. With that being said, we'll see you in the next one.
Peace.